Hello all, welcome to the Pandas for Pentesters course at Pentester Academy. Now in this video, we will look at an extremely interesting feature of NumPy, which is universal functions. So universal functions, or ufunks as they are fondly called, allow us to apply operations on array elements. Now, these can be applied individually, as an example, squaring a number, or rather squaring every element, or collectively as a group, as an example, comparing with another array. So let's jump right into the demo. Okay, so for this example, if you're on Pentester Academy, please download the Universal Functions IPython notebook available below this video. And if you're using this courseware from other sources, then you should find it in the same folder as the videos. So let's go ahead, check the version of NumPy. Seems okay. Now let's actually do an element-wise transform. So the first thing I'm going to do is create an array x of size 10. Now I'm using another little helper function called arrange, which basically is similar to range, right? You can look up the documentation to see where they differ. But np.arrange also once again gives us between 0 to 9, right? Every number. Now, an example of a ufunk is the square function, which we can apply by just calling np.square and passing the nd array as input. And this actually goes ahead, applies the square function on every element and squares it. Similarly, we can now square root the squares to get back the original numbers, right? Which is what we have here. Of course, the key difference what you would find here is that when we do a square root, what we are returned is floats, right? This is expected because generally, as square roots do contain, decimal numbers, I think the square root ufunk ensures that it's kind of giving back a float d type rather than an int d type, even if none of the values has anything beyond the decimal. And we can verify this by noting that z's d type is float 64 while y's is int 64, right? Interesting. Now we can of course even use ufunks with multiple arrays, which is not just the same one. Let's create a 4x4 array of random numbers and another, right? This is A, this is B. Now, what we're going to do is, before we did A greater than B, and this compared every element 1:1, and then gives you this little array. Now, using the ufunk greater, we can do this as well. So we just call np.greater, pass both the arrays in, and it gives us the exact same result. Now, similarly, let's say if we wanted to basically only retain the greater values between A and B, which is for every position, we compare the numbers and return the greater number, right? This can be done using np.maximum A, B. And we'll find, basically, let's pick up a random location. Let's say 394, 488. We are assuming 488 is what should be retained, exactly what was retained. And similarly, np.minimum to actually get an array of the minimum values between A and B, right? Now, this is just the tip of the iceberg. You could even write your own ufunks, or of course, use the ones already built in. And if you kind of scroll down on the link, you would find a ton of them classified by operation type. So you have math operations like add, subtract, multiply, right? Most of them might actually apply to multiple arrays. Some of them might just apply to the same one. So for example, negative seems to be a good example, absolute as an example, right? You also have trigonometric functions, which is all the sine, cosine, and getting those values out. And of course, as expected, most of these actually apply to individual elements of the same array. And then you have bit twiddling functions, comparison functions, and maybe just a couple of other things as well, right? And there is documentation on how to write your own new functs if you so desire. It's a bit complicated, though, can be done. Anyway, so think of ufunks as a quick helper function which you can use to play around with the values in a NumPy array and to do a lot of mathematical operations on them. So this is all I have in this video. If you're enjoying your time at Pentester Academy, please do recommend us to your friends and colleagues in the InfoSec community. Thank you.